What is big data? Big data is an ambiguous and relative term. It may be best to define it by what it is not. It's not regular data. It's not business as usual. It's not something that an experienced data analyst may be ready to deal with. To put it another way, big data is data that doesn't fit well into a familiar analytic paradigm. It won't fit into the rows and columns of an Excel spreadsheet. It can't be analyzed with conventional multiple regression, and it probably won't fit on your normal computer's hard drive anyhow. On the other hand, one way of describing big data is by looking at the three V's of volume, velocity, and variety. These come from an article written by Doug Laney in 2001, and they're taken as the most common characteristics of big data, but they're certainly not the only ones. We'll talk about some other possible V's to consider in big data later in this course. Let's start by looking at the first of the three V's: volume. Volume. In its simplest possible definition, big data is data that's just too big to work on your computer. Obviously, this is a relative definition. What's big for one system at one time is commonplace for another system at another time. That's the general point of Moore's law, a well-known observation in computer science that physical capacity and performance of computers double about every 2 years. For example, an old computer might have 2 megabytes of RAM and an 80 megabyte hard drive, and so, as far as it was concerned, big data is something that would fit onto a $1 flash drive right now. On the other hand, in Excel, the maximum number of rows that you could have in a single spreadsheet has changed over time. Previously, it was 65,000. Now it's over 1 million, which seems like a lot, but if you're logging internet activity where something can occur hundreds or thousands of times per second, you'll reach your 1 million rows very, very quickly. On the other hand, if you're looking at photos or video, and you need to have all of the information in memory at once, you have an entirely different issue. Velocity. For velocity, this is when data is coming in very fast. In conventional scientific research, it could take months to gather data from 100 cases, weeks to analyze the data, and years to get that research published. Not only is this kind of data time-consuming to gather, it's generally static once it's entered, it doesn't change. At the other end of the scale, if you're interested in using data from a social media platform like Twitter, you may have to deal with the so-called fire hose. In fact, right now they're processing about 6,000 tweets globally per second. That works out to 500 million tweets per day and about 200 billion tweets per year. In fact, a neat way to see this is with a live counter on the web. At Internet Live Stats, it's showing us that there are about 435 million tweets that have been sent so far today, and they're updating extremely quickly. Even a simple temperature sensor hooked up to a microprocessor through a serial connection and is sending just one bit of data a time that can eventually overwhelm a computer if left running long enough. Now, this kind of constant influx of data, better known as streaming data, presents special challenges for analysis because the dataset itself is a moving target. If you're accustomed to working with static datasets in a program like SPSS or R, the demands and complexities of streaming data can be very daunting, to say the least. Now, we get to the third aspect of big data: variety. What we mean here is that it's not just the rows and columns of a nicely formatted dataset in a spreadsheet. Instead, you can have many data sheets in many different formats. You can have unstructured text, like books and blog posts and comments on news articles and tweets. One researcher has estimated that 80% of enterprise data may be unstructured, so it's the majority as the common case. This can also include photos and videos and audio. Similarly, data sets that include things like networked graph data, that's social connections data. Or if you're dealing with data sets in what is called NoSQL databases, so you may have graphs of social connections. You may have hierarchical structures and documents. Any number of data formats that don't fit well into the rows and columns of a conventional relational database or a spreadsheet then you can have some very serious analytical challenges. In fact, a recent study by Forrester Research shows that variety is the biggest factor that's leading companies to big data solutions. Do you have to have all three V's? Volume, velocity, and variety at once, or just one? To have big data? It may be true that if you have all three V's at once, then you have big data. What big data means is that you can't use your standard approach with it. As a result, big data can present a number of special challenges.